Welcome to two examples of solving a linear equation in one variable by graphing. A solution to an equation is a value that makes the equation true or satisfies the equation. We most often solve equations algebraically, but in this video, we will solve linear equations graphically using a method called the intersection method. So if we have a linear equation in one variable in the form of f of x equals g of x, then we'll set the left side of the equation equal to y1, the right side of the equation equal to y2, and then graph both linear equations on the same coordinate plane. The x-coordinate of the point of intersection will be our solution. So going back to our first example, we're going to let y1 equal 3x minus 2, and y2 be equal to negative 8. Graphically, we'll determine when y1 is equal to y2. So from the home screen, we'll press y equals and type our linear equations in. So y1 will have 3x minus 2, enter, and then y2 is negative 8. Be careful not to enter minus 8. And now to make sure we have the standard window, let's go ahead and press zoom 6. So there's y1, there's y2. The x-coordinate of the point of intersection will be the solution to our linear equation. To calculate this point of intersection, we'll press second trace, option 5 for intersection. And now we can just press enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. So the point of intersection has coordinates negative 2, negative 8. So the x-coordinate of negative 2 is our solution. And this is the value of x where both sides of the equation are equal to negative 8. So our solution is x equals negative 2. Let's go ahead and verify this algebraically by substituting negative 2 for x to make sure it satisfies the equation. We would have 3 times negative 2 minus 2 equals negative 8. Well, 3 times negative 2 is equal to negative 6. And negative 6 minus 2 is equal to negative 8. So this does verify our solution. And remember, negative 8 was the y-coordinate of the point of intersection. Let's take a look at a second example. Here we have 2 equals 6 minus 2 thirds x. So we'll let y1 be equal to 2. And we'll let y2 be equal to 6 minus 2 thirds x. And now we'll graph both linear equations on the same coordinate plane and determine for which x value they would be equal. So we'll press y equals, clear out the old equations, clear, enter, clear, back up to y1, which is positive 2, enter. And then for y2, I'm going to put the 2 thirds in parentheses. So we'll have 6 minus 2 thirds x, and we'll press graph. So there's y1. There's y2, and again, the x-coordinate of this point of intersection would be the solution to the equation. So once again, we'll press second trace, option 5, enter 3 times. Enter, enter, enter. So the point of intersection is the point 6, 2. So x equals 6 is our solution. And again, let's go ahead and check this algebraically by substituting 6 for x. So we would have 2 equals 6 minus 2 thirds times 6, which I'll write as 6 over 1. So we have 2 equals 6 minus this product. But notice how we have a common factor of 3 here. There's 1 3 in 3 and 2 3's in 6. 2 times 2 is equal to 4. And 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, verifying our solution is correct. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful.